Hello students, welcome to today's video lecture on cooling load calculation.
So what is cooling load basically? The total heat required to be removed from space in order to bring it at the desired temperature by the air conditioning and refrigeration equipment is known as cooling load. So if we want to maintain a particular temperature inside a room, then a certain amount of heat needs to be removed from the space. So that amount of heat which needs to be removed from the space is called as cooling load. The purpose of cooling load is to determine the size of air conditioning and refrigeration equipment that is required to be maintained inside the conditions during the period of maximum outside temperature. The design load is based on the inside and outside design conditions, and it is air conditioning and refrigeration equipment capacity to produce and maintain satisfactory inside conditions. So heat gain is classified in two categories. First is by its mode of entry into the space, and second whether it is sensible or latent heat. So sensible heat is the heat which is directly added to the conditioned space by conduction, convection and or radiation, whereas latent heat is the gain which occurs when water vapors are added to the air of space, example from vapors emitted by occupants and equipments. So now in this figure we can see the various components of cooling load. So we can see that the heat is entering due to the sunlight which is entering through the glass windows, through conduction radiation. Heat is entering through the exterior wall, through the roof, through the floor, through the equipments, through the partition wall, through the lights and equipments which are inside the space, through the people, and heat is also entering through the infiltration. The heat gain through building envelope can be shown in four ways. So first is radiation. So movement of infrared rays through the glass, so which is the main factor of heat gain in summers. Next is the air infiltration, that is leakage of air through the unsealed gaps. So heat enters through the unsealed gaps as well. Next is convection. So heat gain through the air that heat up through warmer glass. So last is conduction. That is direct transfer of heat through the conductive materials. Components of cooling load can be divided into two categories. Firstly, sensible heat and secondly, latent heat. So, first is sensible heat gain, which is due to heat flowing into the building by conduction through exterior walls, floors, ceilings, doors and windows due to the temperature difference on their two sides. The heat received from the solar radiation, which consists of the heat transmitted directly through the glass of windows, ventilators or doors, and the heat absorbed by walls and roofs exposed to solar radiation and later on transferred to room by conduction. Next is the heat conducted through the interior partition from rooms in the same building which are not conditioned. Next is the heat given off by lights, motors, machinery, cooking operations, industrial processes, etc. Next is the heat liberated by the occupants. Next is the heat carried by the outside air which leaks in through the in cracks. Next is the heat gained through the walls of duct carrying conditioned air through the unconditioned space in the building. So next category is latent heat gain, which is due to the moisture in outside air entering by infiltration, the condensation of moisture from the occupants, the condensation of moisture from any process such as cooking foods which take place within the conditioned space. Last is the moisture passing directly into the conditioned space through the permeable wall or partition from outside or from adjoining regions where the water vapor pressure is higher. So firstly, sensible heat gain through building structure by conduction. So the heat gain through a building structure such as walls, floor, ceilings, doors and windows constitutes the major portion of sensible heat load, which is given by Q is equals to UA into TO minus TI. So these are the various factors which are taken into this formula. So this formula can be utilized for calculation of heat transfer inside the conditioned space through the walls, floors, ceilings, doors, windows, etc. Next is the heat gain by conduction through the interior partition from rooms in the same building which are not conditioned. So heat can enter into a particular space from other rooms in the same house or same building. Solar heat gain through the outside walls and roofs. So, as sunlight falls on the outside surface of the wall, so solar heat gain through the outside walls and roofs can be transmitted to the conditioned space. This is the solar temperature, which is a hypothetical temperature used to calculate the heat received by outside surface of a building wall by the combined effect of convection and radiation. The heat received by the outside surface of wall is given by QC equals to FO into TO minus TOS, where FO is outside film coefficient, TO is temperature of outside air, TOS is temperature of the outside surface of the wall. So, after simplifying the whole, we can get that TE is the solar temperature, which is equal to TO plus I into alpha divided by FO, where alpha is the absorptivity of the surface, FO is the outside film coefficient, I is the total radiation intensity. So, importance of solar temperature is in calculating the heat received by the outside surface of building wall by the combined effect of convection and radiation. Next is the solar heat gain through the glass areas. So, through the glass also the solar heat gain can occur. Generally, the value of solar heat gain through the glass areas is given in the questions or is mentioned in the question. Next is heat gain due to infiltration. So, there are various gaps in the windows, in the doors. So, heat gain from these gaps can also occur, which can be calculated by the product of mass into the enthalpy difference between the outside air and the air of the conditioned space. So, heat gain due to infiltration can be calculated by the formula M into enthalpy difference. Next is the heat gain from occupants. So, heat gain inside the conditioned space can occur due to the presence of occupants inside the conditioned space. Generally, the value of sensible heat gain and latent heat gain inside a conditioned space is mentioned or is given. Next is the heat gain from products. So, heat gain or heat emitted from the products to be stored is very important in case of cold storages. The loads to be considered in the cold storages are divided into following four groups. First is chilling load above the freezing temperature. The product chilling load above freezing depends upon the mass of product M, mean specific heat of the product CPM, entering product temperature T1, final product temperature desired as T2, and the chilling time small TCH. Mathematically, chilling load above freezing is given by QCH equals to MCPM T1 minus T2 divided by small TCH. Next is the freezing load, which is given by QF equals to M into HFG divided by TF. Next is the cooling load below freezing, which is given by QC equals to M into C dash of PM into T1 dash minus T2 dash divided by TC. Next is the product reaction or respiration heat. So, during the maturing of some food products, even in cold storage, reaction or respiration heat is evolved. This heat gain is given by QR equal to M into evolution of heat per kg of food per hour. Next is heat gain from lighting equipments such as bulbs, etc. Heat gain from lighting equipments can be calculated by the formula Q equal to total wattage of lights into use factor into allowance factor. Next is the heat gain from power equipments such as motors. So Q of electric motor, QEM, equal to power rating of motor in kilowatt divided by motor efficiency into load factor. The load factor is the fraction of total heat at which the motor is working. Next is the heat gain through ducts. As duct carries the conditioned air, so during the process of carrying air, heat gain in the ducts can occur, which can be taken as QD equal to U into AD into TA minus TS, where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient, AD equal to surface area of the duct, TA equal to temperature of ambient air, and TS equal to temperature of supplier. So these are the various factors through which the heat is added inside the conditioned space and which needs to be removed from the conditioned space, and the heat need to be removed from the conditioned space is called as cooling load. So in this video, we discussed various factors which contribute in cooling load. Thank you.